Hello everyone and welcome to my new video on stock market, where I'm going to discuss about Kaya stock. So I'll discuss about what Kaya is into, so what is their business, and also how this stock can do in the future. So I've discussed about both of this, and also this stock Kaya has been in news like lately. So I'll discuss the reasons also why it has been in news lately. So the title here is, will Kaya be a multi-bagger stock in the future or not? Actually, I didn't add that. So what is the future for Kaya? And what are the, I mean, how it earns money actually? So you should understand both of these things. So why Kaya is in news lately? So it's because of, so Radhakrishnan Damani, he is the second richest man in India. He's also the founder of DMart. He has basically bought 1% stake in Kaya Clinics, that is Kaya stock, in March. And other than, so he bought this in March, but before this, another, I would say, very good investor, that is Purunju Veliyar, he also holds, and he has personal 1% stake in Kaya, plus his PMS, Portfolio Management Service, has additional 1.5% stake in this stock. And you know what happened after, I mean, Radhakrishnan Damani bought 1% stake in this stock. See this graph below. So this is what happened. So if you see this chart here, right, it was close, the price was close to 150, or not 140 maybe. And it has been upper circuit from like last 1 month. I mean, since it came into news that Radhakrishnan Damani, he has bought some stake. And it has been like in upper circuit from then till today. Today the price is close to 287, close to 300. So that's how it happens. I mean, that's the madness of people, right? When they see that somebody very popular investor has bought some stake in some stock, they just go behind it. They do not understand the reason why they have bought. What does this Kaya do actually? What is the business? They don't understand this. They just go blindly. And sometimes it can be very bad for them. So let's try to understand what Kaya actually does. Okay, before that, let's go to my story of Kaya. So this is one of my stock portfolio, but I invested at rupees 374, right? This is the price at which I invested. And during COVID crash, it went to rupees 93, right? That means 74% loss for me. It's not actual loss, it's an unrealized loss because I didn't sell it. I mean, think about it, I didn't sell this stock. It is 74% loss for me, but I didn't sell. So I have become very stable in this because, see, this stock crashed, I understand. But nothing fundamental change happened for this stock. Before also the profits for this stock was, I mean, it was a loss-making company. Now also it's a loss-making company. Nothing fundamental, I mean, change happened, but a stock crashed. So I didn't sell. And also I didn't buy at the levels of 93 because I thought that, okay, COVID crash is there. And this price will not start increasing a lot. I thought that, okay, it will take some time. But then, of course, Radhakrishnan Damani, he entered the stock and it has been like upper circuits every day for 4 weeks, now, more than 4 weeks. Now. Let's understand about Kaya first, what actually Kaya does. So Kaya is actually a leading skin and hair care solution providers in India, as well as UAE and Saudi Arabia, mostly in these three countries. So before, actually in 2003, it started in 2003 and it was a subsidiary of Marico. So Marico stock is there. So this was a subsidiary of Marico. But in 2013, it got demerged from Marico and it got listed separately on the stock market. Of course, Kaya also has a retail business plus Kaya Clinics. So they have clinics for like hair treatment, skin treatment, plus they have retail products also. We will look at retail products later. And Harsh Mariwala is the chairman and managing director of Kaya. And he's also the chairman of Marico also. So the management is very good here. Like, I mean, if you want to know more about Harsh Mariwala, you can read about this. I mean, how he changed a commodity business into Marico. What is Marico today, right? The coconut oil business or parachute, right? How we change that, right? It's quite interesting story, I mean, of that. So he's a very good entrepreneur. And also the management here is very good. It's not that management is not good here. About like, I told you, Kaya is into skin and healthcare. They have a lot of clinics, and most of the clinics are in, I will say, Mumbai, Bangalore, Chennai, Delhi, mostly on Kolkata, these five places, because their business is like, cost is very high. So if you want to do a skin treatment, the cost is, let's say, 4,000 to 5,000. So mostly in metropolitan city, only people will pay 5,000 for a skin treatment. I mean, if you go to some small cities or village, nobody is going to pay that. So they are all over India, but mostly into metropolitan cities. About the growth in India and Middle East, I will say in India, it's going to grow a lot, because if you see, the urbanization is increasing in India. And also Kaya is mostly into, I will say, women treatment, right? Women skin and hair treatment. And also more women are now entering the workforce, plus incomes of for the Indians are also increasing day by day, year by year. So this can have a good effect on Kaya. In the Middle East, it's still challenging because of the economy there. And India also, it's challenging. I mean, it's not that India economy is also not done good in the last 3-4 years. Similarly, Middle East also, it's the same now. But let's see how it turns out. But if you see, their aim is to grow this. And I mean, the growth for this segment actually has a lot of potential in there. So I saw one report, in that was mentioned, this basically skincare and this hair care sector, they can grow at around 20% for next 10 years. That's huge, right? And also the market size for them is around 8,000 crores, right, in India. That's quite huge, but let's see what happens. Of course, this stock depends more on economy. But if the economy does well, more people will earn more, right? And they will spend on their skin treatment or hair treatment. You know, these are not the essential items, right? So opportunities in India, I talked about, right? They are into skin and hair treatment. So anti-aging, laser hair reduction, deep pigmentation solutions, acne and scar treatment, beauty solutions. They are mostly, these are the opportunities for them in India. And they are mostly into this. But what are the risks? Let's also talk about the risk. Of course, economy not doing well is a very, big risk for them. So lower consumer spending, right? This is again another risk. So economy does not do well. People will not spend on these items. Also, Middle East is oil dependent economy, right? And these economies are not doing good now because people are moving away from oil products like petrol, diesel. And Middle East actually comprises 50% of revenues for them, and also most of the profits. We will see that. It's also a very competitive industry. A lot of companies are there in this hair care and I will say beauty, right? In these, many companies are there. And also there are a lot of regulations here. Like if they want to start a new segment, right, for them, they need a lot of approvals. And it's very regulated, I will say. Let's look at the financials. Financials is how they are. So if you see the revenue and EBITDA mix. So revenue, if you see, 50% from Middle East and 50% from India. And if you see in terms of, so they have like retail products and Kaya Clinics as service. So from Kaya Clinics, they earn around 85% of their revenue. From this retail products, that is Kaya Face Wash, Kaya, there are some products like I will mention them later. From this, they earn 15%. If you see the earnings breakup from Middle East, they earn 81% and only 19% from India. Even though if you see revenue mix is 50%, but earning mix is like Middle East is 81%, India is just 19%. So most of, their earnings is dependent on the Middle East. That's one risk, I will say. And very highly dependent on Middle East earnings. Just see the 2019 results. Their net revenue was around 42,038 lakhs, up 5% from last year. Now let's see the expense breakup for them. Like employee cost is 39% of the revenue, right? Then the rental cost is 14% of the revenue. Advertisement is 6% of the revenue. Other expenses are 25%. So if you see, employee cost is very high because they need, good doctors, right? They need good doctors plus. Also, rental cost is high because clinics, right, they need some place to operate, right? So their rental costs, that's also raised, right? The rental cost keeps on increasing. It's already up 9% from the last year. Other expenses are also up 9%, right? And they have decreased the advertisement cost. It's down 17% because they're not making good money. Okay, and leave this. If you see below, right, the main thing is the earnings. So they earn only 295 lakhs from India. That is just 1% of the revenue and 1% margin, right? That's very less. But in the previous year, in the 18, they were in loss actually. -3 was the margin, right? It's still good, right? They are in some profit, right? Earning is in profit. Kaya Middle East, if you see, they earn 1,230 lakhs from them. I mean, from Middle East. So that's 6% operating margin. That's okay. I mean, that's not very good. That's just okay, I'm telling you. But it has increased, right? From 3% margin in 18 to 6% margin. That's, and numbers are improving. That's what we can see from here. But Indian numbers are very bad in terms of earnings. In terms of fundamentals, it's very bad. Return on capital employed is negative because earnings before tax is positive. But if you see the earnings after tax, it's still negative for last 3 to 4 years. Debt to equity ratio is 0.13, not quite high. It's okay, 0.13. They have negative profits after tax from 7-8 quarters. And if you see the stock price, right, it was some 1500 in 2015, right? It went to 93 during the COVID crash and it's 287 now. So if somebody would have bought in 2015 at 1500, right? Loss would have been huge, right? So at that time, the profits was around 35 crores. And it was trading at a price to earning multiple of 60, right? I think that was quite overvalued in 2015. It should not get a valuation of 60 P. The growth in this, if you see the growth they are showing is just 4 to 5% every year. And the PE was 50. Not sure why, because I started investing last 3 years, so I am not much aware of this. But if you see that current price at the same profits, if you see 35 crores, if they do, their revenues has increased from 15. Because 15, the earning was 300 crores. Now it's around 450 odd crores now. But let's say if the same profits they are able to churn in future, 35 crores, today the price to earning is just 12. So I will say it's not... I would say it's undervalued. If the growth comes in, it's undervalued at this profit. I'm just making a guess of the profits. It may be higher than that because their revenue has increased. Let's see the quarterly results, if it is changing or not. If I see the last three quarters, right, the margins are good. 13%, 14%, 16%, it's increasing. That's a positive sign for them. And also, I told you, right, profits are in loss, right? Only the operating profit is in positive. That's good. 13, 14, 16 is increasing. But still, they have depreciation interest, right? After this, if you see the profits, it's still negative. It's like zero here. And every time it's negative, right? They have not shown any positive profit before tax. And after tax, again, it becomes more negative. EPS is negative for all the quarters. Right. So this is of course a loss-making company, but we are seeing the numbers are improving. That's what we have seen here. Cash flow statement, if you see, they have now some good, at least they have operating cash actually. So in 17, it was negative, if you see here. This is in billions. So it was negative, 18 negative, 19, okay, positive. And trailing 12 months is again positive. So that's good for this stock. Investment, they are doing investment also, opening new clinics. So a lot of investment goes in this. So that's okay. That's negative because they are doing investment. Financing, mostly they have some loans and giving that. But free cash flow, if you see, it's been negative, right? That's, I'll say, bad for any business if your company does not have a free cash flow. But I would say they are still into investing phase. That's okay. But my question is that if they want to expand more, from where they will get the money, right? But they are not earning a lot from their business, right? So they do not have money to expand. They have to take loan if they want to expand now. I'm not telling they are not expanding, they're expanding, but they have less money to expand. You get it? they are using the operating profits for expansion, but their operating profits is very low now. They cannot like expand aggressive like DMart can, right? DMart is very aggressive into expansion. They cannot do this. For that, they have to take loan again if they want. Okay, I went to some like I was just seeing the reviews for this their product, though they are clinics, of course. So I was just seeing like mostly in Bangalore, Delhi, and Mumbai. In Mumbai, they have the highest clinics. So the reviews are okay. I mean, for mostly I saw like for all the clinics, it's from in the on the Just Dial site. I saw that this is close to around 3.94. So I think it's okay. The reviews are okay. I'm not bad here from the Kaya clinics. And I also went to Amazon where they sell. I told they are also into selling retail products like this. Kaya Youth face wash, Kaya Clinic acne free purifying cleaner. These all retail products they have. And even here the reviews are good. I mean, normally 4-star or 3.5, like close to 4. So it's good here on Amazon also. I have also used their face wash and it was quite good from my review. Again, some other products also. So most of the reviews I see are good. It's not all of the reviews are good. Because these products are, I mean, if you're not satisfied, you will give a very low rating, right, on this. Okay, this was all about Kaya. So what, how Kaya earns money, right, through this beauty and skincare, hair care products, and they have clinics also. And mostly, I will say the revenues for them mostly are coming from 50-50% from India and Middle East. But most of the earnings are coming still from Middle East. So if Middle East economy does not do well, this stock is also not going to do well. Or otherwise, they have to diversify more in India and increase the earnings from India. Well, I think India is a good, India can do very good for them in the long term. So this is not a short term stock. This would be like if you want to wait for a very long time, this will take time, right? This will take very long time. I'm showing the results for this. So if you are willing to wait maybe 10 years, maybe that type, this is that type of a stock. You have to wait for a long time to see the improvements in the results. So it of course is a very risky stock. This can crash again to 80-90% again. And I'm giving a warning, it can crash again. Now you are seeing it's upper circuit every day. But once some other news comes out, the earnings come out, again people will change their mood, and every day you will see again maybe lower circuit 5% maybe. So it's a very risky stock in that sense. Multi-bagger or wealth destructor, I think it totally depends on management here. Management is very good. I mean, I talked about Mariwala, right? He's a great entrepreneur. I mean, so it all depends on the management here, how they take this in the future. Opportunity is there in India. And of course, I do not know much about Middle East, but the opportunity should be there even in Middle East. Also, if you see more women earning plus increasing incomes, so opportunity is there. And of course, they are also increasing the retail online sales like face wash and acne creams. So they are aggressive on this and they're increasing the sales from retail segment. But the Middle East market is very challenging and management has also told the same. So watch out for the management commentary in the future. I mean, and also the quarterly results every quarter. Watch out for them and keep the note of like if their margins are increasing, how much the Indian business is improving, see the earnings, right? See the margins, how they are. And take decision on that, mostly based on that. And I will also take decision mostly on based on this, like if I want to invest more or not, or should I wait? So my decision also will be based mostly on this. So yeah, that's all for this video. And do not forget to subscribe to my channel. And also if you want similar videos on other stocks, do comment in the comment section. Thank you.